every game when it comes to shooters has good and bad maps. Good maps are usually pretty well balanced. They have decent routes, good lines of sight. Bad maps are usually not balanced at all. One side has a humongous advantage, and it pisses everybody off. St. Petrograd, actually, in my opinion, was a good map. And I say was because you're going to hear why in a minute. An example of a bad map. Let's say Arklov Peak, maybe? The map where, you know, you basically... Any map where defense or offense, frankly, has total and utter control of both bomb sites just unanimously is typically not a good map. You want to promote some aggression. You need people to have to move forward and hopefully contest a bomb site, and that's a healthy, you know, it's a healthy map. St. Petrograd, B was heavily given to defense. You spawn on top of it. A was the highly contested bomb site. And offense did have an advantage there, for sure. But it wasn't insane. I can very, very easily run inside of A with double time and get in to the point where I'm able to help control the bomb site from the enemy team. I don't think it's bad at all. I wouldn't say it's totally balanced, but it's much better than, like I said, Arklov Peak or even Ashair Cave. Ashair? We like to call it Ashair Cave now. I like that name for it. Ashair Cave. You know, that one's heavily defensive. You spawn, and both bomb sites are controlled by defense off the bat. There's not much you can do about it. People don't enjoy it at all. Thanks for going off, phone. I always need that. Let's just mute that right there. But one of the updates, or one of the changes in the last update, was to Petrograd here. And you might not notice it, because on defense, I look like I'm spawning in the same spot, and I am. But on offense, they're spawning like 20 feet backwards. And you even see the guy type it right here. Did they change the spawns on this map? He's confused. He doesn't know why we're able to get to him so quickly. It's not the fact that we spawned forward. He just spawned further backwards, which gives defense total control of A and B. Total control. Now, if you wanted to go and defend A very easily, you can just run straight in. If you wanted to go to A on offense now, you're going to see us do it. And thankfully, their team isn't really highly skilled. They're not even contesting it, frankly. But it's not an easy bomb site to push. I'll explain why in a minute. But this map went from being what I would consider to be a healthy search and destroy map, or a good map in general, to a map that now kind of sucks balls. Kind of is shitty. And when a game only has 8 playable maps, and you already have some that suck, like Peak is not great, Cave is not great, Shoot House is kind of a shit show, but it's acceptable. It's decent. It's better than those two, honestly, in my opinion. When you only have 8 playable maps for Search and Destroy, to kind of screw up one of them is a pretty big hit, you know? 1 of 8 is a large percentage of maps now that I got to play that I don't think are very good anymore. It's definitely not unbearable, and it's not unplayable. And some people are like, well, you just go B then. Defense has control of B. Okay, they have control of A as well. At least control of A, they have to move a little bit forward more. B, they just basically spawn on top of. You can just run to the left, climb up on boxes, and camp the head glitch of the roof and wait. And you win. There's nothing you can do. It's not healthy for the game atmosphere. So here you go. Look how far back we are. We're against the barrier. Normally you spawn by the yellow car. So 1-1000, 2-1000, basically 2 seconds of your total. I think it's 4 seconds you get in super speed, whatever, your super sprint, is used just to get back to where you spawned beforehand. And you can get to that green car right there, and that's about as far as you can get up. If they wanted to rush right through tunnel now, they can get to the tunnel, throw a grenade at green car, and they can kill every single player on your team, which is ridiculous. That's absolutely nuts. That's so wrong. They either need to change the spawns back, or they need to move the spawn forward a little bit more. I mean, it's just not even at all. It's not even at all. And frankly, I don't know why they changed it. I don't know anybody that was complaining heavily. If you're complaining about this map, you sure as shit should be complaining about Ashair Cave. That map blows dick. It sucks every time you play it. And defense has total, utter control of both bomb sites. So if you got people complaining about Petrograd, there is no question that you should fucking change Ashair Cave. because that map is dick. It's awful. So right here, if I get to this point, me and my teammate, a grenade comes, we both die. Like I said, the enemy team, they didn't even know the map spawns had changed yet, so thankfully they weren't on the up and up. But if they were, me and my teammate both could have died every round because we only know one route, and that's to instantly try to push into A to get control of it. Otherwise, we just have to kind of push ourselves slowly through B, cover every line of sight, and hopefully kill the people who are camping, which is not always going to happen, really. But the reason I'm making this video, and I wanted to talk about good and bad maps before I go into the context of this, which I know it's near the end of the video at this point, but they just released a change into the game without addressing it prior and without putting it in the patch notes. From what I saw, I read through it a couple times, never saw it once, and they basically just bombed and ripped apart one of the maps that was decent and ruined it. And as I mentioned, one out of eight maps being shit on is not a good percentage. We're already playing on a couple bad maps. We're at the point now where like 35-40% of the maps are kind of shit and are not good for search versus the 20%. Because, you know, it's like 8%. What's what, 15? That's not 15, is it? No, a little bit less. 13, 12. 12%. 1 out of 8. 12%. Something like that. Listen, math's hard, okay? I haven't been in school for years. But that's just shitty. An undocumented change that basically just shit on a map. The first time I played it, I literally rage quit. Look, they're throwing grenades. They're kind of figuring out as the game goes on. But they're throwing grenades already. You get no control now, and it's turning into Ass Air Cave again. We're getting to two of them. It's not going to be as bad because technically there are more lines of sight and lanes that you can take than you could on Cave. But still, it's becoming the same thing where both bomb sites are given to defense and offense is getting screwed over. And that shouldn't happen. It shouldn't happen the reverse way either. Offense should not be given both bombs and defense shouldn't be getting screwed over. That shouldn't happen either. This map was defense gets one bomb and the other bomb site is contestable, which is a pretty healthy search and destroy map. Frankly, a lot of maps are like that. If you'd like another example of a very popular one that people really enjoyed, Standoff was a good example. Standoff was very, very strong on playground side for defense, and the middle was kind of the contestable site, but you could play both relatively well. If you have a both bomb sites that are contestable, that's a very good map. It's a very good map. But very often, that's not how it works. So, what do they do to fix it? Change the spawns back.